team, and that's going to be very, very high as she follows a 9-9-0 by Potterack. Brandi Johnson, the U.S.'s best vaulter.
Watch the power here. Laid out Yurchenko, and she way overdid it. She is so juiced, she is so explosive, that sometimes she just overdoes it. A little bit like our own Mary Lou Retton.
Hope Spivey had a 9.85 and Phoebe Mills a 9.80.
Good position on the board. Nice and high throughout the vault, but you can see she way over-rotated it. Now, there is an advantage to the girls because she's going to get another chance to do this vault. And what she's going to try and do is block a little more there so she can hang it up in the air a little longer. So rather than over-rotating as she does there, she'll drop straight down on it. Let's see if she can block just a little bit more.
Selavaj scores another 10 on the beam. Oh, and that's a tough number to earn on such a difficult apparatus. Brandi Johnson going for second vault as Aurelia Dobre up last on the beam for the Romanians.
Let's watch for the block. Oh, she didn't quite do it.
So Dobre, beautiful young Romanian.
Dobre is perhaps one of the most flexible gymnasts in the competition. And she, took a big step out of that back handspring. She really uses her flexibility, though, to her advantage because she moves so nicely in nice fluid movements. Here's an acrobatic series. Backhand layout to a back straddle down. She looks a little tentative. She actually seems a little nervous. Normally she's right on, and she's had a few minor shoulder wobbles, which of course aren't major deductions, but it does tend to let you think that she is a little bit off. Not on that dismount though.
So the 15-year-old from Bucharest following perfection, Silavash, has scored a 10. And we see her overhead view, Dobre. And we'll bring you up to date on Brandi Johnson's score after these words from your local. Two rotations to go, and the story thus far is the fact that two top gymnasts in this Olympic competition, Elena Shushunova of the Soviet Union and Daniela Silavash of Romania, both have hit 10s on their first two rotations, and Aurelia Dobre a 9.9. Let's take a look now at the rotations. After the two rotations, the score of the Soviet Union, 1.2 points in front, and apparently on their way toward the inevitable gold to continue that long string of their excellence in Olympic competition. Bulgaria still in third. The United States a very close fourth. They've competed well. East Germany with a handicap of only five gymnasts, so they can't throw out any low score. All of them count. And then China. So the U.S. continues in fine position. Still a chance at a possible bronze. Rhonda Fain being on the podium. A technicality penalty against the U.S. They'd have 2.92, 9.50. They'd be in third place in front of Bulgaria. Oh, would that be something if that five-tenths of a point really decides a medal? Here's Hope Spivey. She's second up on the uneven bars.
Giant with a full. Nice. Oh! She was just too far out on that cross-change front.
How much of a deduction for that?
No question. That's a half a point for a fall off the bars. That's going to hurt the U.S. team.
Even though she caught, made a great catch, a recovery, it's still a major break. Kelly Garrison-Steves had started with a 9.75, so a good start, and Hope Spivey with a problem. Baitova on the beam for the Soviet Union.
Wow, what an opening tumbling sequence. Back handspring, layout, layout.
16 years old from Mogilev.
Back straddle down. Oh. Kovalchukova has to be the most denied of all the Soviet gymnasts. She took 4 fourth places in last year's World Championships. Did not get a bronze. She was fourth in the all-around, fourth in the vault, fourth in the bars, and fourth in the floor.
Looks a little like Kathy Rigby, who was the star of the 1972 U.S. team.
Here's a dismount. Triple full. What a start for the Soviets on beam.
Meanwhile, Hope Spivey, 9.275.
Watch this sequence now. It's a back handspring. She takes off 2 feet to a layout, steps down, and another layout. It's a great angle to see the full turn, which, of course, is a requirement on the balance beam.
And Missy Marlowe, the United States on the uneven with a 9.275 by Spivey. Now the United States cannot afford another major break if they want to entertain any hopes for a bronze. The rest of the way on the unevens, they all must be good.
Beautiful reverse heck for Missy. Giant. Komenich dismount, one step on the landing.
Melissa Marlowe. We're in the third rotation, another to go after this. And we'll continue from Gymnastics Hall F. The men's team title and the Soviet women are on their way to defending a rare kind of run. It's like the U.S. men's basketball. Every Olympics in which they have competed, they have won the team gold medal. That goes all the way back to 1952.
It's very exciting to watch the Soviets because they're not just satisfied with first place. They always choose to try and take gymnastics to a new dimension. And you can see Olga Strazheva on the beam. She did a move called a Healy twirl down, which was invented on the parallel bars for men, and yet she adapted it for the balance beam.
Since they arrived, the Romanians and Soviets have tried to get into the practice sessions and watch each other. Soviets shut the doors on the Romanians yesterday. And that's Brandi Johnson of the United States on the uneven bars.
Wow, and what a reverse hecht. That sequence in the middle, she was having trouble with that two release moves back to back, and she was having problems. She got through it nicely, and Strazheva is off the beam.
And appears to have injured herself as Brandi Johnson completes her routine. We can tell you that the U.S. scored a 9.875, Shelley Stack, Missy Marlowe a 9.775 since Spivey fell off. And now, oh, this could be very serious for the Soviet Union. Let's watch how the injury occurred.
Well, let's see. She was doing a back handspring. This is the layout. We saw Baitova do this. Looks like her right foot is a little bit off to the right. Of course, she tries to compensate. She really is fighting this a lot. Ooh. What a shock.
Mary Lou, as you looked at it, you've battled that terrible piece of apparatus, the beam, before.
Balance beam definitely is the hardest to compete, especially in a pressure situation such as a team all around. You have four events going, you hear the floor music in the back. You hear the clicking of the cameras of the photographers on the side. It is a pressure event, and it's just very difficult to block all the distractions out of your mind.
Looks like she twisted a knee. You couldn't see it as it happened. Here's Phoebe Mills, last up on the uneven bars. National champion, 9-9 for Brandi Johnson, preceding her.
What an inspired U.S. team. And Phoebe, of course, is having a terrific competition throughout. She has looked so good in the preparation for this event. Two reverse hex, the second one she caught with a mixed grip. Giant with a full to a tuck double back.
15-year-old Phoebe Mills. Three U.S. members are 15. There are 8 15-year-olds of the 24 involved in this competition, one-third. 15 means that they weren't born when Olga Korbut was competing in Munich in 1972. It's a game for youth, and that's why they've had to put an age limit. These gymnasts must be at least 15 in the year of the Olympics.